friends. Happy Friday. It is just before 6:30 a.m. and I just got to my WW workshop. But before I go in, I wanted to fill you guys in on my week, let you know how things went. So this week was crazy. I, on Wednesday, filmed my life update that you guys will be seeing on Sunday. A lot of you have reached out to me asking if everything is okay and just kind of wanting to know what's going on since I've been alluding to a big life change coming down the pipe over the last couple of months. So it finally all worked itself out. So I'm able to record and upload that entire life update for you that will be up on this Sunday. So don't miss that video. I'm giving you all the detail. I'm spilling all the tea. So that'll be up on Sunday. So with that being said, this week was just really busy. A lot of filming. I was actually in a class all day yesterday, Thursday, from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. So it's just been a really busy week. And on top of that, I started Shark Week. Why wouldn't I? Why wouldn't I start Shark Week right before I have to weigh in? So welcome to my life. This happens to me, it seems like, every single month. So I haven't been feeling the best either this week. I've been really tired and run down, which is typical for me. It's been a week. So hopefully the scale isn't bad. I had a good eating week this week for the most part. We did splurge on Saturday, but we worked out in our yard the entire day and I probably burned like 9 of my splurge meals. So I don't think that my food was the issue this last week. I was on track all week. I made good food choices, so I'm hoping that that shows up on the scale, but you never know with Shark Week. That's the joys of being a woman once a month. You never know how it's going to affect your weigh-in. So we'll see, but yeah, I'm gonna head into my workshop. I'll be back to not only give you a recap of what we talked about, but to share my weigh-in. So cross your fingers for me, guys. Guys, I just got out of my WW workshop. It was awesome as usual. So I'm really excited about the topic that we discussed. It's something that I think that we forget about. We're so focused on our weight loss journey, and in order to lose weight, we think we need activity, which we generally do. We need some sort of activity. But I think a lot of us end up doing activity that we don't necessarily love or that we're not excited about because we feel like we have to do the activity. We go to the gym every day because we know that's what we need to do to be successful on our weight loss journey. We go on our walk every day because it's our routine. It's what we think we need to do to be successful on our journey. But are we really taking awe in our activity? And that was what the topic was this week. Seeking awe in the activity that you're doing. So for example, if you are a walker and you go the same route every day, maybe change your route up a little bit. Go in reverse. Walk the opposite way that you normally do. So instead of starting at one point, start at the finishing point. Get a different perspective. Walk when the sun is rising or the sun is setting and enjoy what you're seeing. I think a really good way to think about this is if you were to go on a hike and you're going on a rough hike, I mean a long hike, hike full of hills, trials, tribulations, it's a hike. But if there are gorgeous flowers around and trees and animals and scenery, you kind of forget that you're on a treacherous hike. You forget about the hills you're hiking up. You forget about the distance because you're in awe of your surroundings. And I think that by choosing activity that makes us feel a sense of awe, I think the activity, in my opinion, is going to be a lot easier. So a way that we can do this is start by picking a place that you've never been, a new place that you want to explore. Or again, start your typical walking route in reverse. You've never seen those areas at that perspective. So start there. And here's another tip. Leave your phone at home and really enjoy your walk, your activity. Take it all in. Take in the smells, the sights, the sounds. Take it all in and don't be focused on your phone, responding to your messages, reading your email, watching YouTube. Go on a walk all by yourself and really take in your surroundings. Feel that sense of awe. Focus on what's new and exciting. Feel the pavement beneath your feet. Focus on your environment. What's new that you've never noticed before? What's different? Are you seeing different flowers, different animals, different trees? What are you seeing that's different? Did your neighbor mow their grass? I mean, even these small little details, really take it all in and notice the small things. Not only does it make the achiness, the long walk, the tiredness completely go away, you really are soaking in and absorbing your surroundings, which I think is really important. I know for myself, when I go on my walk every morning, I watch YouTube. So I'm listening to my phone, I'm looking down at my phone, I'm not really paying attention to my surroundings. And you know, I live in a gorgeous area, and it is very rare that I actually even notice what's going on around me. I am a true testament to the bring your phone and pay attention to that. So I, on Monday, on my walk, am not bringing my phone. I'm really going to soak up my surroundings. I'm going to pay attention to what is in front of me, the gorgeousness of my walk every day. And maybe I'll see something new or different or something I never saw before. And I'm really going to soak in the awe of my activity versus just doing it to get it done and to watch some YouTube. I'm really going to soak it all in. And the more you get into the moment on your activity, the more you'll be in the moment in your daily life. You'll really start to see things in a different perspective. You'll start to be more appreciative of your surroundings and the things that are going on in just your day-to-day life. So I think not only is it beneficial for your activity, it's beneficial for your daily life. So my challenge to you guys is the next time that you do your activity, even in a gym setting, really soak it all in. Soak up your surroundings, soak up what you're doing, and really enjoy it. Seek awe in what you're doing rather than just trying to get it done so you can see some results on the scale. So let's talk about this week's weigh-in. As I mentioned before I went into my workshop, it is my shark week. Love it. So that plays into, of course, how your body is retaining fluid and water. I feel okay. I feel pretty good. When I stepped on the scale, though, I was up 0.6. And I know that that isn't very much considering it's Shark Week, but I didn't want to be up. I was up a little 0.2 last week. So now I'm 0.8 up in the last 2 weeks. So I am clearly not moving in the right direction. And I want to blame it all on Shark Week, but I don't know that it was all Shark Week. I feel like I had a really good week of eating. My activity wasn't as great as it has been the last few weeks just because everything that's been going on has been really busy. So yeah, I'm a little disappointed that I was up the 0.6, but I am going to take it as a positive thing. I'm going to blame it on Shark Week, even though I don't know that it's entirely Shark Week. And it's just going to fuel my fire for this next week. I'm going to be better on my activity. I'm going to take awe in my activity. I'm going to enjoy it. And I'm going to see, mark my words, a loss on the scale next week. So no ifs, ands, or buts, you're going to see a loss on the scale next week. So not the best weigh-in, a little disappointed, not moving in the direction that I need to be moving in, but it's my body. I can't help what it does sometimes. We can be perfect angels and on plan all week and not see results on the scale. So hopefully it all just kind of picks up and it drops off this next week. So this week is going to be a week of activity. It's going to be a week of absorbing my environment and really focusing on that in my day-to-day life as well as in my activity. It's going to be a week of being on plan. My husband and I still have quite a lot of bark to shovel on Saturday, so I'm going to get a lot of activity in again this Saturday. So I'm looking forward to a fantastic week. Again, if you are not part of my Facebook group, we just hit 7,000 people, you guys. That is so crazy to me. Make sure you hop on over. I'll put it right there and take part in my Facebook group. It is such an amazing place. We just are wrapping up our challenge today that we did last week. We did tons of fun giveaways. There's just a lot of fun things and inspiration and ideas and recipes on my Facebook group. So definitely check it out. Also, if you don't follow me on Instagram, make sure that you follow me there, right there on Instagram as well. I do post stories almost daily, show you my food. It's just another good way to stay on track and to stay in touch. So that's it for me, guys. I'm hoping for a really good loss this next week. And like I said, I will have a loss, guarantee that. I want to hear in the comments, how was your week? Did you gain? Did you lose? Was it what you expected? What do you think about really absorbing and taking in and having awe in the activity that you're doing? So leave me some comments down below. If you're new, welcome. Make sure you subscribe. Hit the little bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Please thumbs up this one. And again, let me know how your week went down in the comments below. Stay tuned next for a little video of the recipe on the back of the weekly. It looks really good. And I'll see you guys all in my next video. Bye, guys.